Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this session, we are going to see how to deploy your paginated reports built using Report Builder in Power BI services. If you are not so familiar with what I meant by it, let's try to understand it in a diagram way. So this is the architecture of Power BI, where till now you might have worked on Power BI Desktop, that is used to create your BI dashboards, that is for the consolidated data, and you can publish in services. Whatever we are seeing as part of this playlist, we are creating the Power BI Report Builder paginated reports using Power BI Report Builder. And what we are going to do, we are going to publish into Power BI services. That is what we are going to see. One quick note I want to make here is, like, till now, whatever you have seen in this playlist, I have a SQL source here, right? So from this SQL source, I have read this Power BI report, and we are only seen till this time only within this Power BI report builder. Now, once I publish it, I need some gateways. This gateway should connect to my SQL over here. That is, the gateway is over here. This gateway should connect to my SQL, right? This is the way it should work. There are some issues while I configure this gateway, so that is what I need a separate approach. What I did right now, I'm trying to explain it right. So basically, now I created one report in Power BI Desktop. This report I have deployed in Power BI service. I use the data set. Once you deploy the reports in the services using Power BI Desktop, you have a report and data set separately. This data set I've used here to create a Power BI report builder. Then I'm going to publish it, right? So this is what I'm going to do it right now, basically in order to understand. Once I fix that data gateway issues related to SQL and other things, I will try to explain it in a separate video. For now, you should understand how you can publish it. That is what, quick note. To make you clear, those who are following my channel or this playlist, they should not confuse why I've changed this route. This is because one of the issue I'm facing right now. This may not be the case in your case. Try to deploy directly from SQL. Once you build from SQL, you try to deploy. Okay, that is different story. So we are going to follow this approach, right? Let's begin. So what are the prerequisites? You should have Power BI Pro or Premium per user license. That is the one of the prerequisites to deploy into Power BI services. And you can deploy it in my workspace or other workspaces. Ensure that your workspace is in a premium capacity. So once you have a premium capacity in that workspace, you can able to deploy your reports. Then on-premise data gateway. So you should have some gateways to connect to your Power BI data as well. If your data is in on-premise, if it's in Azure or some other data source, the story is different. So these are some of the prerequisites. It ensure you have this one of them, then we will go for it. Now let's do whatever we explained so far. So now you can see this is the report. Earlier I have some data source, that is data source from SQL. Now this is the data source which is reading from the Power BI services. You can see this data source is reading from the Power BI services. I have this particular report. Let me launch and show it to you what it is having right now. And you can see this is the premium per user workspace, that is premium capacity. And you can see from this diagram, so this is the end-to-end report that you, those who are following my channel, they have a tower. We have that end-to-end reports. So this is one of the report which contains report as well as data set. What I'm trying to do here, I connect to this data set in the Power BI paginated reports, right? End-to-end. Then I created one data set, right? So I mapped it here. So once you run this one, it will show me the data that is fetched from the Power BI data set. So this report I'm going to publish it in the Power BI report server. Now you can see, once you do the publish, now here is the catch. As I said, this workspace should be a premium capacity workspace. So click on this. I already deployed it. So once you click on publish, it will be published in that particular website, I mean workspace. If you are deploying in non-premium capacity workspace, it will not allow. So once you click on it, open, that is, you can see now the report, whatever you developed till now, is deploying it in the Power BI services. You can see same report, whatever we have seen in the report builder, that will start appearing in your Power BI services as well. So this is a dedicated report only meant for Power BI report, paginated reports. So how you can embed Power BI paginated reports in Power BI, that will be a separate video. I will explain it later. Now you can see from here, the report data set, and you can see the difference between the reports. This is the Power BI report, this is the Power BI data set, whereas the paginated reports contains the report. The icon is slightly different from the Power BI reports. Both lies in the same workspace. I hope you understand how you can deploy it. It is just a simple one-step process. Like once you develop your report, just publish it in the Power BI premium capacity workspace. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button, comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.